Just give me a minute. Sorry, just give me a minute for some administrative.
Do you need me
Jaya
to
and
co-host?
Magadhi? Yes, please. I'm just making you co-host, Lenny. I was just making
sure.
Jaya and Pragati also co-hosts. Thank you, Lenny. All right, wish everyone a very, very happy new year. Thank you for joining us today. As you might be aware, Jan and Feb, we have a special initiative called the Spotlight. The Spotlight is all about inviting the learned, experienced members of our very own ICF Bengaluru chapter to lead the sessions for us. Many of people in the chapter have led sessions for us during the year. And we, at the MC, we felt that there are so many heavyweights amongst us. There's a wealth of knowledge and experience within our members itself. And therefore, we wanted to use these 2 months to focus our attention on just learning from each other and connecting with each other as a chapter. As the very first initiative of that, I'm super excited to invite Jaya Bhatija, who is based in NCR, but is very happily part of our chapter. Thank you for being part of our chapter, Jaya. And today she's supported by Pragati Mehta. So welcome, Pragati, to ICF's Bengaluru Charter Chapter. As we start 2022, there are many of us, including me, who believe that what is this whole purpose of doing a goal or a vision in the beginning of the year? Should it be in the beginning of year? Why can't you do it on the 25th of December? And so on and so forth. But the thought that I'm sitting here, when I'm sitting here today, is that the year's last two have been difficult. This year promises to start on a challenging note all over again. And I'm looking forward to creating a strong vision for myself that will help anchor me for the year, that will possibly inspire me, ignite my passions, keep me focused, and everything that I need to kind of keep myself positive as the year goes by. And I'm inviting all of you also to bring your whole self into our session today as Jaya and Pragati lead us through the session today, helping us create our vision for 2022. And they want to do that using a very beautiful tool that they have developed called the Meraki cards. And I'm not going to say anything more about it, but I'm going to let them speak. But a quick brief introduction to both. Jaya is a master certified coach from ICF. She runs a boutique leadership and coaching education firm by the name of Abhyudaya. She's been the recipient of several global recognitions, one of them being the Young Leader Award by ICF in 2019. Pragati is a senior human resource professional, and she's also a leadership assessor and coach. And she and Jaya have kind of created the Meraki cards together. I also kind of saw on your LinkedIn profile, Pragati, which I found very interesting, which is that outside of work, she's also interested in subjects like energy healing, tarot card reading, and journaling. Wow, how interesting. So maybe we'll bring you back in another time for to talk about these. But for now, over to you, Jaya and Pragati.
Thank you, Jayashree. First of all, thank you for inviting us. And I do want to admit that being part of Bangalore chapter is really an honor, because I get to meet such senior seasoned elite coaches here, and I get to learn so much whenever I'm able to join any session. So thank you for being here. Thank you for choosing to be here, rather. And today we're gonna just facilitate a process of creating a vision through a mystic process of Meraki cards. And the little bit of context around Meraki cards is Meraki cards basically has changed its name several times, like any other tool it happens, and finally landed at Meraki, which resonated with me and Pragati. The premise of it was that we were trying to create something which talks to our subconscious without too much of logic in it. And we said, okay, let us see what we can do, which can tell the story of the clues and the signs that you get when you draw the quad. So that's what we have tried doing through Meraki. Let's go through the experience today to see what happens. And as I was preparing for the session today, I was just sitting in the sun for a little bit of reflection. It's quite cold in Delhi. And suddenly I saw dry leaves dropping out of the green lush plants that I was watching. And it kind of gave me an indication that everything has to come to an end and a new start comes in. And since we're talking about vision for the next year, even if the leaves were dry, it had to drop, and nature doesn't stop, and we are nature. And how do we continue looking optimistically, even if last 2 years had been extremely difficult for all of us? So before we move forward to the vision, I would like all of you to spend some time reflecting on your 2021 through the Meraki framework. I'm just bringing it up. And the full form, actually, will just give me a minute, please. So here are some questions for all of you to reflect on. And I'm going to play some music for you to just indulge in that reflection to see what happened. What meaning did you take out of this year that went by? And just spend some time with yourself. You want to switch off your video, switch off your video, just sink in for some time. We'll give you around 5 minutes to do this reflection through these cards. Meraki's full form, basically it's an acronym. M stands for meaning, E stands for energy, R stands for relationship, A stands for attention, K for knowledge, and I for innovation. So some of the questions that you can reflect on is, what is the meaning of life you made in last 2 years or last year? Where did you spend most of your energy? What are your key learnings about relationships? What invited your attention last year? What did you add to your knowledge? And in what way did you innovate in your life? Let's just spend some time on reflecting before we move forward. And it's very, very important to understand that before you move forward, we have to settle down with the last year so that there is enough energy for us to look positively ahead, irrespective of how many departures we have seen. Irrespective of how many hard times we have seen, how many hearts have been broken, how many relationships have been tarnished, whatever it is, let's put it to a closure before we move forward. So just giving you some time to reflect on it. Thank you. Welcome back. And as you come back, whatever needs to be done, whether forgiven or kept aside, or even required to be revisited, do that in silence and then we move forward. So the way we're going to go about this next few minutes is we have uploaded the Meraki cards on a site where the link will be given to you. But before that, I want you to write down four numbers between 1 to 54. There are 54 cards. Look at 2022 forward, give your good energy to it, and write down four numbers between 1 to 54. See what your energy draws. What are those four numbers? And once you have done it, okay, Pankaj, you've shared your number. Okay. So it's 1, 7, 17, 28, is it?
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
Okay, awesome. Sure. So Chitra, you have to think about four numbers between 1 to 54. There are numbers on each card. There are 54 cards. That's the reason. All right.
JR, do we need to share it on the chat? Yeah.
You can keep it with you. You can share it also. It doesn't matter. I'm going to give you a link where you will go and find your cards and take the screenshot of those four cards. Also, to save time, keep a blank presentation ready so that you can insert all those four and see it together. So these are some of the arrangements we did because we are playing it virtually. Otherwise, you could have folded your cards in your hand. So keep a presentation ready, blank one. And here is this link. Go find your card there. Take the screenshot of four cards and put it on a blank slide. And just spend some time looking at it. What came your way? What are the clues Meraki is giving you for your next year? What is the story? And once you have done that, I'm inviting Pragati to tell you how to interpret those cards. And then we'll put you into breakout rooms to have those conversations. And then you come back, share your reflections. So I'll wait. I don't want to run. I'll wait for you to take the screenshot of your four cards. Everybody can access the site. Anybody facing an issue?
Jaya, are these jumbled up or I'm seeing so?
It's jumbled up.
Okay, thank you.
And can you see just one card at a time or it's showing multiple cards on the screen?
It'll show two cards at the same time.
Yeah.
So this is how the site looks. You can just find your number. This is what you're seeing? This is how you see it?
Yes, yes. Right.
So just find, you say Control F. Type your number. Control F works on the site.
Okay.
Find your number. Take a screenshot. You have four cards with you.
Okay. Thank you.
There are 54 cards. Once you're done, just let me know so that I can move forward. And I'm now inviting Pragati, once you have done it. Once you have inserted on your presentation, put all your four cards together so that you can see them together.
Hi, Jaya. I'm not able to move the cards. How shall I go about it? If you can just write.
It's just a scroll, Archana. Just scroll the page. The card won't be movable. The page is movable. Yes.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you. I can see that.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. Thank you.
Okay. So for the ones who have already done it, is there anything emerging already?
One small thing. It shows multiple cards. So do I take the screenshot of the multiple cards?
You're taking the screenshot of the four cards, the four numbers that you have chosen. You're searching those numbers and taking the screenshot of those four.
Okay. Thank you.
It would be nice to hear from some people if there is something already emerging for you. Any surprises? Anything? Okay, so I'm assuming everybody's done. Can we move forward? Give me a sign.
Just a minute.
Okay.
Yeah, it's slightly complex. So if you can give us a couple of minutes, please.
Surely. Please let me know. Yes, absolutely. Okay.
Jaya, effectively we'll have eight cards, right?
You'll have four
cards. They come in pairs.
No, they don't come in pairs. There are two different cards. You should have four cards with you.
How do I cut one out?
You can just take the screenshot of one card instead of taking the whole thing.
But
do you mean the picture and the words by two cards? I think they are together.
Okay, one second. So this is how it's looking?
Yes.
So this is one card. The nine that you, this is one card. This is the other card.
Yeah, so how do you take a screenshot of half of a page?
Okay, so if you're using... So
Jaya, what I did was just did a
right click,
control C and control V.
Control C, control V. Yeah.
Yeah, I think you can also save the card. You can just right click and you'll find
save image.
Okay. Got that. Copy image.
Drag it on your onto your desktop.
Yeah. So you should have four cards at the end.
Okay.
This is far more simpler actually.
So you know, we don't know whether for some people screenshot is more simpler and for some people saving. So I just wanted to keep it simple. But eventually.
Yeah, the right click works very well.
Right, absolutely.
Okay, then just give us another minute.
No worries. Take your time. No hurry.
It's very interesting.
Yeah. Okay. Has the
very magical actually.
Okay. We'll get to the place of reflection. Let's spend more time on them. Once it is all there, can we go to the interpretation? Can we tell you the interpretation before we get into the breakout rooms? So, Pragati, over to you. Can you share the interpretation on these cards? Pragati, you're there?
Yeah, am I audible now?
Yes, I can hear you. Yeah.
So thanks, Jaya, for setting the context. And I'm happy to share with all of you as to how can you interpret each of these cards that you've got. So you would have selected four of them and every card would have five clues. The first clue is the image. So you can look at the picture carefully, what's there in the foreground, what's there in the background, reflect on the kind of clues that you're getting from the picture. So on the right side of the card, there are again four more clues. The first one is an element of Meraki. So Meraki is actually an acronym. So where M stands for meaning, E for energy, R for relationship, A for attention, K for knowledge, and I for innovation. So you don't really need to memorize this. The only thing that you need to be aware about is that this word on the top, in the left side of the card would be one of the elements of Meraki. And then the third clue would be a question. So as coaches, we all know the power of question and what it can bring up, right? So that's with that intent, we have a unique question placed on each of the cards. So there are 54 questions in the deck. The other one, the fourth clue, is a symbol. Now, for us to be able to understand the symbol in detail, Jaya, I'll just request you to go on to the next slide. So this actually is based on a model, which is we do have. As coaches, some of you may already be aware about it, but then for all of us to be on the same page, I just want to mention that how this works. So B is who somebody is at the core. So who you are at the core, what your purpose is, your values are, the vision, the beliefs, the mental models that you operate with is what that's what who you are at the core, and that is what B is. And when you see this symbol, that's what B would be indicating. When you see the other symbol, which is this bird flying, that is more about the actions or the do part. The do part actually is about the choices you make, the options that you have, that you take up, the habits that you operate from. So it's more about the action or the doing part. And then have is more about the experience that you have, the skills, the knowledge, or the tools that you already possess, and the way you acknowledge them. So these three, one of the three symbols would be there on each of the card that you will get. So here we have a symbol for B. However, you may have a combination symbol depending on the kind of cards that you've drawn. And the fifth clue is again a word. Now this word we'll have to see in the context of the clue too. So here, for example, it says physical as fifth clue, and two is energy. So the physical aspect of the energy is what we are talking about. So therefore you can look at the fifth clue in the context of second. So that's something that you can note. Now that you have an information about how to interpret the cards, you can look at it in totality, look it all together, and then in the context of the vision for 2022, what's coming up is what the reflections are going to be about. And any questions that any of you may have, you could ask, and otherwise, Jay, you may take it forward.
Can you show the previous slide?
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah. So somewhere the card is giving you a clue either about looking at the aspect of being or looking at the aspect of action or getting something, experience, knowledge, tools, skills, or something. Okay, and the five clues as Pragati explained. Yeah, now no point getting too much into the analytics of it. Idea is just see what is coming up immediately when you see all your four cards, right? And when you go to the breakout rooms of 3 to 4 people, what you're required to do is, number one, spend some time on your cards to see what is it telling you. How is it talking to you? Let it communicate with you, number one. Number two, as an output, create one metaphor, draw one metaphor that summarizes or synthesizes everything for you through those four cards. Questions for me?
So if you bring up the slide again, it had, I think I didn't catch the fourth item there.
Here.
Yeah, HDB. After reflection.
So basically, when you're looking at four cards on your presentation, spend some time to see what is it telling you, how is it communicating to you, and as a synthesis, create one metaphor for 2022. So for example, when you look at four cards, you may think candle as a metaphor for you, or an eagle, or any metaphor that resonates with you, your story, because somewhere or the other, all of us have thought through how your year has to be. But what is that one symbol that can keep you on track? What is that one symbol that can motivate you? What is that metaphor that can give you energy to stay on your track? What's that symbol?
Jay, one small request. Can you just go to the previous slide? I just need to take a look. Yeah, thank you.
If you want to take a screenshot of these two slides, it's fine if it helps you.
Okay.
Okay, can I move forward?
Yes, please.
Awesome. So now I'm putting you in breakout rooms for almost 20 minutes, wherein you're going to do two things. One, look at the story. Look at how these cards are communicating to you. And number two, as an output, synthesize it in a form of a metaphor. And write whatever you want to write, but create a metaphor that can give you energy in 2022. I see some questions. What does it mean to have only be and do? You will only have one. Either you'll have, or you'll have be, or you'll have do, which means it is indicating for you to focus on that aspect. If it is do, it is telling you to take an action. If it is have, it is telling you to acquire a knowledge or a skill or learn something about it. If it is about be, it is telling you to look into yourself and say, look at the aspect of being. Is that clear, Suresh? Okay. All right. Any questions before we...
Yeah. Sorry, Jaya. Are you saying that what is on the card is what it is indicating that is something pending for you?
It's... So
it means, inviting you to look at that aspect.
It's inviting you. Yeah. And you may have all three because you have four cards. You may have all three.
And I have two of them and they're repeating. So then there's something there. Yeah. Okay. Right.
There's something there. So the cards are inviting and communicating to you. Sure. Just spend some time looking at it. Sure. All right. So you are in breakout room for 20 minutes. And then once you're back, let's see what metaphor comes out and then we'll do a reflection conversation.
There are three not assigned, Jaya.
Yeah, they just joined, right? So I'll just see if I, but we'll have to explain the activity to them. Okay. So anybody who just joined, can we have you on camera so they can explain the activity to you?
Yeah, Jayashree, very sorry. I mixed up the times. I just joined now. Bakhtiar from Lahore.
No problem, Bakhtiar. So let me just explain the activity once again. Mm-hmm. What we are really doing is we're trying to create a vision for 2022. And mm-hmm. we started with doing a reflection on 2021. Now, since we want to try to catch up with everybody, you can do the reflection on 2021 later. But right now, what everybody is doing in the breakout room is, here is a link of a site. You can think about four numbers, first of all, between 1 to 54. Just write down four numbers for yourself. Mm-hmm. Quickly write down four numbers.
From 1 to 54.
Yeah, anything between 1 to 54, including 1 and 54. Mm-hmm. And go to this link and the cards are uploaded. There are 54 cards. The cards are uploaded there. Find the number that you chose. Find the card and save that card and put that on a presentation. Let me know once you're done so that I can assign you to rooms. You can actually continue doing that while you're in your rooms because your roommate would know what to do.
So how do we take the card
Right click, save the image.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, so you got four cards, and now you can put all the four cards on a blank presentation to see it together. All right, welcome everyone. So what did Meraki cards do to you? We have 10 minutes. Let's do some quick sharing. What metaphor came for you? What happened when you looked at your four cards? Anyone who would like to share?
So can I go first? Kamakshi. It's
Kamakshi.
Yeah. So these cards are really fantastic, to be very honest. They have connected to, like, I could connect to them very well. And the metaphor is flow for me.
Sorry, which? What is
it? It is flow.
Flow, okay.
Yeah.
What did you draw a wind or something? What did you draw?
It's a river.
It's a river, awesome.
River flowing, yeah. So this is what I have seen, because there are, like, I have all the three states, do, be, and have. And I have two do's. So there are two actions which I have to do, and there is one reflection which I need to look on, and one have. What is that which I need to have? Where it was spoken about flexibility. So I'm just looking into it, and I think this is quite awesome. I enjoyed it thoroughly. Thanks a lot, Jaya.
Happy for you.
Yeah, so can I go next?
Yes.
Can I go next?
Please.
Okay, so this is Ravi, and
Ravi.
My basic thing was really leap of faith. And that's where I am. And this really helped me to come to that point. Have faith in yourself and just jump. And that's the metaphor. Thank you.
Awesome. So did you draw somebody taking a leap? What did you draw?
I just draw the thing. I mean, I didn't really draw, but I just sketch of, you know, you being on the edge and then you just taking a jump is what I did.
Sure. Thank you. And this is an important paper for you. So keep it, all of you, keep it in front of you, 2022. All right. Who want to go next?
May I?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. So it's beautiful, amazing that I drew three elements only, two of meaning and one of relationship and one of attention. And I'm not surprised, because knowledge and innovation somehow have never been my trip in life. Knowing is not knowledge. Energy at this moment after near-death encounter with corona is like in the sub-zero. So, but the meaning that it, you know, it evoked makes perfect sense at this point in time in life for me. And the metaphor that came up was like Kamakshi, river. And flow was one of the words. The other words that jumped out of me were that river for me is simple and deep at the same time. So simplicity, depth, flow, fertility, grace, all these words, they came up when the metaphor of river came. And it's amazing that I have been using tarot extensively for 2 decades now, in my counseling work more than anything else. But every time somebody else is inviting me into this space, the beauty of card work, the symbology is such that at least I reach there empty. So none of my background comes with me. And I guess others also, because symbology just allows the unconscious to bubble out. And so it's a beautiful, powerful, emptying space.
Thank you. And I'm reminded.
And the elements were more do. So the call perhaps from universe is stop being too much. Start doing.
Focus on action.
Focus on action. Bahut aaram ho gaya.
Yeah, and one of the quotation I'm reminded of with the metaphor of river is river never remains the same. It's changed.
Yes.
The moment you put your feet into it and you take it out and you put it again, the river is changed. So the versatility and the dynamicity of river is something, it is encouraging us to change every moment, every day, every moment. Be dynamic, accept change fast. Awesome. Who would like to go next?
Thank you. I would like to go next. I'm Dr. Kalindi from Pune. Okay. For me, the metaphor would be a group of people climbing the hill with the torch in the hand and supporting each other to climb the hill.
Interesting. And how is that talking to you?
Yeah, so for me, priority, using my physical energy, courage and innovation, and changing my mindset when it comes to relationships. So take more people along.
Uh-huh. Interesting. Who's going next? We have 5 minutes, 4 minutes now.
I have to say that I also had the river.
Oh, see, how many rivers do we have today? There is a group energy talking.
I think there's just the difference is it's a gentle flow, flowing movement of the river. Because I tend to do a lot and really run fast. And I think that was a beauty. And I just want to say it's an incredible process. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for
participating. So I would like to share.
Yes, Johnny.
So I was struggling with this in the breakout, and Durga was kind enough to help me with this card. But as I'm listening, something came to my mind about the metaphor is that of germination. So and it involves decay and then sprout.
Yes.
So I think that's my experience of 2021 and into 2022. And I shared in detail in my breakout room. And the metaphor that comes to me is that sprouting and then coming up into green, like what Sindhu has behind her, the plant in the thing. Yeah, that's
awesome.
Okay, can I go next?
Yes, Pankaj.
Yeah, so for metaphor for me is that of a Deepak or Diya, as you know. It's with the fairly stable kind of flame. And so to me, that metaphor also shows it's lighting, its own light. Lighted in it, but it's not for a particular direction. It's just light goes in all direction equally. So, interestingly, I have this, one of these things is direction. One of the cards says direction, and it has have actually, and priority, which has have. So it kind of indicating mean that you need to have some direction and priority. But to me, it looks like, sometimes you see when energy is reversed, what it shows me to drop all the, whatever remaining directions and priorities also. And do away with this and just be, though I didn't have any be of this, but be of being yourself, and life will unfold without having any direction or any priority. And one of my card is self, which is also says have. So something to do with help, which is what I think, perhaps I need to drop the idea of self also. So the have is, to me, the have is not having.
Mm-hmm.
So not having the concept of self, concept of priority, and concept of direction. Just dropping all of that.
And the air doesn't light up for itself. It lights up for others.
Right.
Thank you, Pankaj. Who would like to go next?
Can I go next?
Sure.
Havobi from Mumbai. So this process has been really beautiful. And the cards did help me get to my metaphor, but now my metaphor is helping me decipher. So the metaphor that I got in my mind was that of a road. It's a huge highway with an arrow pointing forward. And then on both sides of the road, there are different things which have meaning for me. On one side is beauty, which is nature. There's a river flowing, there's beautiful mountains, and there's a lot of greenery. And on the other side, there are a lot of people. So for me, it's about doing while being and feeling supported in the process. I think that's the imagery that I have drawn.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing. Jayashree, how much permission do I have to go ahead?
Go ahead for a couple of minutes more. And after that, if you do have time, Jaya, mm-hmm. then we'll have a formal close to the session.
Sure.
But I'm willing to keep the Zoom open for another 10, 15 minutes for those who want to stay back in case you have the time to connect and reflect. Is that all right?
Yeah, I have time. And I also have a little bit of music for meditating and creating more intention towards 2022. So if a few more people would like to share, we can hear those reflections and then go to the meditation and then close the session.
Sure. Maybe if we could have one or two people share and then we'll close the session for those who need to move out for anything else. And then we'll stay back to continue.
I would like to share. Sorry.
Yeah. Please go ahead.
No. Mr. Bhaktiyar, you can then go ahead then I can do it after you.
I joined very late, but I learned from others how to connect the dots. So the four images that I saw, the various clues pointed towards getting an image of the rising sun, and the metaphor that the term that comes to my mind is purpose. Nothing moves without purpose.
Awesome. Thank you. And sun has a purpose every day.
Yeah.
Thank you. Seema, you wanted to share? Okay. Any other share? The last share.
Can I go ahead?
Sure, Sunil.
Yeah. So what connected me with the four dots is the metaphor of water flow. Mm-hmm. It's something which says mean card is for some time, forget about your past and flow freely into the future in the new transition. So that's what something coming to my mind. Leave the baggage for some time and just like a flow of water, just free yourself and flow into the next as it comes.
Thank you for sharing. Great. So let's create more intention for whatever has come up for you and how you would like to see it happening in reality. Just playing some music for you to settle down, take some deep breaths, create more intention, create more energy around what you're looking forward to do this year. Thank you so much for your presence. Thank you for choosing to be here. Really grateful. Me and Pragati are really grateful for your presence. Over to you, Jayashree.
Thank you so much, Jaya and Pragati. And before I invite Lenny to, give us the formal word of thanks for today, quick mention, next week, 17th, 6:30 p.m., We have our very own PK Narayanan, who's going to get us back into business, talking about the business of coaching, insights from his extensive experience. The link is there on the chat. I think it's gone up. I shall reshare the link. But your emails will come into you, and so will the WhatsApp groups. But if anybody would like to go ahead and register right now, the link is there on the chat. Over to you, Lenny.
Thanks so much, Jaya and Prakriti. I think it was a fantastic session, a very different session in the sense you brought in a sense of mysticism and a different experiential sort of space. And I think everybody just loved it and so well timed in the beginning of the year. Jayashree, as usual, you've done a good job in terms of deciding who comes when, and the fact that you have been, you know, working with all our members and the community and fraternity. Thanks so much, Jaya and Prakriti, for sharing all that you have brought to the table. And I hope we can reach out individually and collectively to see what else we can do together and how this can help us in terms of not only just coaching, but everyday life, right? I mean, it's so powerful it can be. So thank you so very much for accepting the invitation from ICF Bangalore chapter. And guys, as Jayashree just shared, please reach out if there's any of you who would like to share some of the things that are precious to you that you would like us to know about. We would be delighted for all our members to benefit from it. And it's also a chance to showcase what wealth we have within this fraternity for all of us to benefit from. So thank you so much for being here. Thank you. Thanks, Jayashree, for getting this organized as well.
Thank you so much, Lenny. And we are happy to keep it open for some more time for those who want to stay back and interact with Jaya and Prakriti. And do join in next week at 6:30. Jaya. So over to you, Jaya, and anyone else would like to unmute, share, please go ahead.
Yeah.
Jaya, this is Saurabh. I was very intrigued with this number. So what is the, if I can ask, secret behind this? How does that really come together, or is it just random set of cards?
Well, there is a mysticism there. Your subconscious is choosing a number and there is some number on the card. So there is no formula to that. There is a framework we designed and we have tried to cover a lot of piece of it. So Meraki and Habdubi come together to create a combination on which we have created questions. So number is really, I think, your subconscious, like it said, that you don't choose the number, you don't choose the card chooses you. So that's how we are. There is a lot of unanswered stuff here and totally believe in universal energy. So that's what I can say, Saurabh.
Thank you. Understood.
So what got you to create these set of cards, Jaya? What was your journey in arriving at this?
So Lenny, we were trying to actually reach to a playful act of creating awareness. And that's when it came into, and as I said, you know, Meraki has changed its name various times and several frameworks have changed. So we were trying to say, hey, can there be some tool which is not aligned to any logic? And there is a mysticism so that there can be interpretation, because we are all meaning making people. So how can we create something like that? So that's where it came into play. And obviously it had to be backed up with a framework and question. So we said, okay, let's give a lot of clues rather than one clue, because there are other tools which give you either picture or either question. And we say, okay, can we see if there are more, there can be a story which can be weaved.
Right. I love the symbolism and the imagery, because that immediately connects with the right side of the brain, even if you have to look at it logically in terms of association.
Yeah, that was also the idea, that how do you connect the left brain and the right brain together? Right. And whoever is looking at it can make some meaning out of it. So it can't be like extreme right and extreme left. So how can we create a combination?
Jaya and Prakriti, I don't know if this is kind of mindful or there's some synchronicity in this, but yesterday when I was just looking up, Googling up Meraki, because this was I was quite intrigued by the word. I found a play puzzle on Amazon by the name Meraki.
Okay.
So when you say that playful way of generating awareness, you know, there's some kind of a synchronicity in it.
Maybe, because yeah. So I'm sure a lot of you, I mean, now know that Pragati has a background in tarot reading. And she was very sure about creating something which is related to that concept, but also has coaching connected to it. So that has also played a role in this. And Meraki was also her idea as a name. And while I was telling her, you know what, corporates, people don't like these words and this and that. And she said, just believe in me and just let's do it. So all those conversations we had in the background.
So actually connecting coaching with mysticism and, you know, not interpreting it by ourselves, but giving it to the person who's getting coached to be able to derive meaning, draw insights is what was kind of, you know, behind all of that. And like Jaya very rightly said, to make the sessions interesting, have some playful energy, have a combination of something from the right, left brain. So everything coming together is what led to kind of the genesis of this tool.
Which is what tarot is all about, you know. It's about connection with the unconscious. Unfortunately, it's kind of got trivialized as a fortune telling kind of a thing, which is what it is not about.
So, anybody would like, Sindhu, I remember you were about to share your reflection. I think it was time. Would you like to share now?
You noticed me. No, like I ended last year wanting to have a proper direction and gain more clarity into who I want to be, what I want to do. And those are the exact two things that came up. And I was really surprised and shocked to a level. And in terms of metaphor, one of the words kept coming to my mind from the moment I started answering those initial framework questions, which was balance. And then the image I had was a seesaw, but tilted seesaw. It's not perfectly in balance, but a tilted seesaw, which means that something in more and something in less is the balance for me for this year. So what do I do more and what do I do a bit less than what I have been doing? That's something that I have to really reflect and understand. But it's really, really very insightful.
Thank you. Thank you, Sindhu. There is actually no word called balance.
Yeah.
It's just our sense of it.
Yeah.
All right. Anything else? Anyone want to know more about Meraki can connect with us, either me or Pragati, either on LinkedIn or email. I've given my email ID there. Pragati has also given her email ID. Happy to have more conversations on this.
Can we have your numbers also?
Oh, yes, I can write it. That's my number. I can reach out. And anything more you want to know about Meraki, please do not hesitate to reach out. Thank you for your time once again. And we take your leave here. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you everyone so much for being here. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Jaya. And thank you, Pragati.
Thanks, everyone.
And thanks, Jayashree and Lini for organizing this.
Thank you, Johnny. And I'm still waiting to speak to you for your session, Michelle. Speak about
not
it.
I'm not going to leave you, Johnny.
No, I'm not going to leave you.
Thank you all very much.